This speckle tracking course is meant to be practical. After completion, you can use speckle tracking in your daily clinical practice in even more indications if you haven't done so far. Together with numerous key opinion leaders, we're going to show you a lot of cases, show you what the literature knows about speckle tracking at this point, and of course, we'll also share our personal experience with you. So what's inside and how does it work? What you see here is part one, the compendium, the basics of speckle tracking. Then, if you want to go further, we have part two with more advanced content. In the compendium, you learn the basics of speckle tracking. We'll focus mainly on longitudinal strain. We'll mainly use the bullseye display, and we'll focus only on the left ventricle. In part two, of course, we'll expand on this knowledge. You'll learn more about the advanced technologies behind speckle tracking. We'll also include information on radial and circumferential strain. We'll look at the curves, and we'll look at other chambers of the heart as well, such as the right ventricle and the left atrium. I'm quite sure you see a lot of patients, no matter in which environment you work. And in many of these situations, of course, it's very important to determine what the function of the left ventricle is. Now, here are some specific scenarios that I'm sure you will encounter. The patient who has severe hypertension with left ventricle hypertrophy, where the question is, does this patient really have normal left ventricle function? Or this patient here with aortic stenosis, no matter if he has symptoms or if he doesn't have symptoms, it's very important because based on these findings, you will treat the patient differently. And then you've got the patient who comes in with chest pain, where you are looking for regional wall motion abnormalities. Now, this might be very difficult, especially in situations where patients might not have such good image quality. And then finally, sometimes patients come in where you're not really sure, is this patient healthy or not? Where you have to figure out, is this maybe some form of dilated cardiomyopathy in an early stage? Or is this just a normal patient who has subnormal left ventricle function? Now, in all of these situations, it would be really helpful if we would have another tool, aside from ejection fraction, to tell us how left ventricle function truly is. Now, obviously, I'm going to propose speckle tracking as the technique that might help you. But I'm not alone with the opinion that speckle tracking is a very, very valuable tool and that it has a bright future in echocardiography.
I think today we should really use strain in everyday clinical practice because we have it on our machines. There is clear evidence that it can really give us new information that we would not get by conventional echocardiography.
Over the years, a lot of developments in echocardiography come and go, but I'm excited about this strain imaging using speckle tracking, and particularly the global longitudinal peak systolic strain. I think that number will have some application in changing our way of approaching a patient, and one example is ventricular dysfunction in cardio-oncology, for example. But I'm still waiting for a bigger body of work to come to clearly define the value of strain in various disorders.
Strain is a new technology that's absolutely ready for prime time. It is on a collision course for clinical use. The only variable is time. We are already using it in many different areas, and in the future, I suspect we'll use it even more.
Global longitudinal strain, which is something of an equivalent to the ejection fraction, can be used and should be used in patients, especially when we are looking at subclinical myocardial dysfunction. So these are patients, especially in a country like India, where we have diabetes, we have the thyroid, we have hypertension, and if we can detect the subclinical dysfunction, and at some point of time when the global longitudinal strain becomes an added parameter, and hopefully it can get into some sort of guidelines, and maybe it can be some sort of a management parameter, I think that would be good.
I believe that speckle tracking should be part of every echocardiographic exam. It's a very useful thing. It's quite easy to learn. It provides a lot of additional information. It has very important added value. And it's not very time consuming. So in the busy environment of Echolab, it gives a lot of help with the price of little time.
The main advantage of deformation imaging is that it gives you an objective and quantifiable view on cardiac function.
So I hope you're convinced that it's important to learn speckle tracking and that it's worthwhile to watch this course. Now, let's go on and let's go to a topic which I think is important to understand before we go into the whole issue of speckle tracking, and that is the role of ejection fraction. But I'm afraid I first have to destroy your belief in ejection fraction. But remember, fresh grass only grows on burnt soil.